Welcome to the Pioneer TV Newscast, your source for West Haddon community news. We appreciate you tuning in. I'm Lainey Casanova.
And I'm Tylan Alden. It's common for Americans to begin the new year with some sort of fitness goal. How about trying something that doesn't involve a traditional gym environment?
We go to Yangvu with something to mix up your New Year's resolution to get in shape.
It can be a daunting task to keep your New Year's resolutions. The frustration of an unused gym membership or reminders of failed resolutions can make you feel hopeless. Let's take a look into a program called CrossFit that can liven up your routine and keep you on the right course.
We have First Sergeant Michael Grijalva, our resident CrossFit instructor, explain to us what is CrossFit.
What we're doing is we're trying to incorporate functional movements, everyday movements that we do throughout the day, squats. Typical what would a mom do from point A to point B. We all do different things throughout the day, but there's common things that we all do as human beings. It doesn't matter how big you are, how small you are, the workouts equalize themselves. So although I may not be as strong as that bigger guy to do as many reps at, you know, a certain weight, I know that I can continue to go and make it up with my pull-ups, my body weight movements.
Also, when asked how CrossFit changes lives, Michael Grijalva had this to say.
My kids who are being successful in wrestling now because of CrossFit, or came to me who's, you know, 50, 60 years old and hasn't had great mobility, and all of a sudden you see her doing full range of motion squats and just being healthier and happier about yourself. That's the biggest thing, is just the repercussions of seeing people succeed and have more success in life in general than they had before with CrossFit.
CrossFit features many high-intensity exercises that don't require gym equipment. So, if you want to find out more about CrossFit, visit their website at CrossFit.com. This is Yang Vu signing off for Pioneer TV.
Thanks, Yang. I may need to try that sometime. Anyway, you may know about Wichita State's nationally ranked basketball team, but did you know they have their very own ice hockey team just down the street?
We go to Tylan Oliver with a feature on one of their resident hockey players.
The Wichita Ice Center plays host to a multitude of events in the Wichita area. Among those events is the Level 1 Adult Hockey League, featuring players with elite skill level and some even with professional backgrounds. Among these players is one determined WSU player who has worked all of his life on perfecting his craft.
My name's Scott Rosendale, and I play right wing and center. I've played hockey ever since I've been 2 years old. I started skating when I was two. I grew up in Canada, and I played professionally for about 11 years, and from major junior to professional here in Wichita, and just really enjoy the game, and I love what hockey brings out in you.
When it comes to hockey, Scott is not the first in his family to fall in love with the sport, as it seems the passion for hockey runs through the blood of the Rosendale family.
Well, my father played junior at a high level and was a really good defenseman and kind of taught me the ropes of how to play and got me on the ice early when I was a kid, 2 years old. Like I said, my mom taught me how to skate and with my dad, and you know, just growing and loving the game. I mean, you get out there, it's one of the most freeing feelings that you can feel, you know, just skating around and being able to get out there and kind of push yourself to the limit.
Though his journey to play the sport he loves has been an enjoyable one, it has also been one that has come with its fair share of obstacles along the way.
One of the biggest sacrifices is just time. You know, you give a lot of time to the game, playing on multiple teams growing up, and one of the big things was when I was drafted to play junior hockey. I moved away from home when I was 15 years old, so I had to adapt to a bunch of new school environments and things like that. So just getting to learn and meet new people was probably the biggest challenge that I had to endure, and meet new guys. But it's really nice to meet a lot of new people and play the game you love.
And for anyone that might be interested in trying their hand at hockey or any of the other events that the Ice Center offers, Scott has a few words of wisdom that anyone can live by.
You get to challenge yourself quite a bit, learn a new skill. Skating, first of all, is a real tough thing. But, you know, anybody can come down here to the skating rink and learn a little bit about skating. They have skating classes, different things like that. It's just a real fun game. Like I said, it's camaraderie, really, with the guys. You get to pat guys on the back and say, you know, you did a great job and good play. And I think really it's all about just having fun.
Many accolades follow the West High swim team, with at least 7 members going to state this year. 2 of these swimmers specialize in crazy maneuvers above the water. We dive in with our very own Lainey Casanova with a scoop on West High's 2 elite divers.
We
could have the number one and number two diver in the city. And it's our second season. So I just think that's amazing. That shows how hard these boys work and how great of diving coach that we have.
While ranked as two of the highest divers in Wichita, both Dominic Jones and David Garcia have had different paths to get them prepared for diving.
I was swimming at Ailey and the lifeguard see me. I raced a lifeguard one time and he thought I should join.
I learned on my own. My mom just threw me in the pool and was like, if you want to survive, swim.
Learning how to dive came with struggles for both swimmers. One had a simple issue while the other dealt with his earlier in the season.
Breathing. I couldn't breathe. Too much work.
I get a lot of cramps at the beginning of the year, and I always get sick around December.
Coach McCullough attributes their raw athleticism and positive characteristics that they bring to the team.
They both have great characteristics. They're both hardworking. They are amazing athletes.
If you ask the two their favorite maneuver while in the air, the answer comes easy.
My favorite dive is probably the reverse 1.5 with the half twist.
I really like back dive. It makes you feel like you're falling backwards. It's just awesome.
We've seen them in the hallways, brightening our day and supporting everything we do at West High. Basketball season for the IHOL team is a chance for students at West to repay the continued support.
Erica Stanford gives us an inside look at the basketball season so far of Hogan's Heroes.
Loud cheers, happy faces, enthusiastic players. Most would assume these sounds and images would come from an NBA game, but they're actually from supportive students and staff at West High. These kids and teachers all do not share the same classroom. They share the same love, basketball. Not only do these students work very hard in their classrooms, they work just as hard on the court. Practicing just a couple days a week, they work with each other and their coaches, continuously building skill while also having fun. We caught up with a few of the coaches and even a student ref to see what their perspective on the game looked like.
We've been doing it for more than 4 years. I think it's both. You know, our kids are really competitive, but you know, they like getting out there and winning. But I mean, to me, it's mostly for them to have fun. Well, it's important for the kids, you know, to feel a part of the school. And feel as just as any other student would, you know, like that's part of a team.
It's much fun to watch them play and have fun and enjoy themselves.
As the bleachers fill up and all players line up for a much anticipated game, Mr. Hogan and the student's coach remind us just how much the support of the West High student body means to not only the players, but themselves as well.
The biggest thing is the fact that it's important for the kids to be interactive with other students. It's really nice when we have home games because students from West are there watching and they really enjoy the crowd. They like the competition of the teams, but it's also having fun. And that's the biggest thing, the enjoyment of playing.
So if you see these students in the hall, continue to support them off the court just as you did in the game. Because they're always enthusiastic and eager, whether it's hyping it up on the court or hyping it up in the classroom. This is Terica Staniford, signing off for Pioneer TV.
We end our February episode of Pioneer TV with a West High cinematography piece by Juwan Sanders and Jackson Cousins.
Until next time, keep calm and pioneer on!